So hello and welcome back to Let's Play American Truck Simulator. If you remember, in the previous episode we came up to Winnemucca when I failed to remember that we were stopping over here, but we carried on and only just made it to this rest stop where we rested up, and it is now around 5 a.m. It's an amazing sort of sunrise that we got going on. Just look at the clouds as well, it looks absolutely epic. But if we jump in, I forgot to put my truck IR hat on, so I'll do that quickly. What an absolute fail that was. I wondered then, like, why is truck IR not working? Have I not started it? No, I didn't even put the hat on. Good start. Right, let's put it in neutral. So as you can see, we have got 8 gallons of fuel left, which is not a lot, as it'll only do us 59 miles. So what we need to do is we need to find somewhere to fuel up, and that seems pretty perfect. So we'll head down there, and then once we've got there, we'll have a look at what jobs are available, because yeah, I still want to push us closer to getting that brand new truck. There we go. It's quite tight, that. Nobody coming. Saying that, it is really early in the morning, so I wouldn't really expect them to. That sound. I think I said this in my Exploring France video recently, that the difference between the trucks and trucks in America and then trucks in Europe are so large, really. With the American trucks, I've noticed they seem a lot more raw, and you really have to rev them out to get the best out of them. However, the European trucks seem perfectly happy to just rev up to around 1400 RPM. You can rev them out, the European trucks, but you get the impression that they don't want to. However, with these, they really do like being pushed quite a lot. And if we try it now, if I shift around 1500, it just feels like the truck's got so much more to give. I find it hard to choose what gear to be in. Right, here we go. Yeah, if I shift here, yeah, it doesn't seem right. I mean, that's that wall painting that I was looking at recently. Not sure if it's like a famous thing or not. Look at that. Some kind of park here as well. See it? Epic. Right, let's pull up here. I don't know if you just heard that, but there's a massive thunderstorm going outside, and it was the loudest sort of crash. I honestly thought something went wrong or something, but I even picked it up on the microphone then. And this microphone can hardly pick someone up from the other side of the room. I just felt everything shake. Honestly, that's one of the loudest thunder crashes I've ever heard. But yeah, so now there's a thunderstorm going on outside, and I thought I saw some lightning when I was recording just out the corner of my eye, but pretty cool. I do love thunderstorms. Okay, so we're all full now, so let's have a look at the job market, freight market, Winnemucca. Alright, what we got? Cayenta, I don't know how to say that. Yuma, Oxnard. I think it's probably time to go back out of Nevada now. We've done most of it, to be honest. Carson City. Yeah. Let's have a look at external contracts. Holbrook. What's that? 15. Hang on. If we go down by price per distance, LA. What I think I might do that seems pretty good. $70 per mile, all the way down to Kayenta. And I wanted to go down here anyway because I think there's some kind of Easter egg sort of thing going on. So I want to head down there. We could split it into two episodes pretty easily. Maybe try and get to Las Vegas by the end of this one, and then carry on in Arizona for the rest of it. But it is a hazardous cargo. It's a standard delivery, so there's no rush or anything. So that sounds pretty good, and we should see if we can get it as a double trailer. Hopefully we can. Okay, so we're full. I wonder if we can do this on a single tank of fuel. I would be interested. I'm just gonna move my microphone back a tad, because I was knocking it on the wheel then. Let's move my seat. I'm good to go. I had to quickly move to have a look at that thunderstorm outside, because I love watching them, as I said. So I quickly stopped the video and see, started watching it, but it doesn't look like anything's happening now. I think I missed the best of it. But here we are at Gallon. I do love that Gallon logo. Looks epic. And then I love this pickup as well, all these sort of, don't know what they are, refinery things. Right, freight market. Right, so we can edit it, but we can't go for a double. It's a bit of a shame that I haven't really seen that many doubles. It is kind of annoying. But propane, 18 tons of it, down to Kayenta, that's what we want. In fact, if we change it to the gas tank trailer, that'd be 14 tons, but we're only getting paid 58. You see that? So I think they have changed that, because before you could just take any trailer and it wouldn't make any difference to the price, but they've now edited that, which is a good thing. And it's now gone to really heavy rain outside. Wow. I'm sorry if I keep looking over like that. I am looking out the window. I do get distracted a bit. Right. Here we go. Look at this. It looks epic. All these pipes going everywhere. Probably could have turned in a bit better than that. Shame that you can't see yourself in the reflection. There we go, all attached. And let's get going. Right then, so we're in gear, 18 tons. Let's have a quick look at the route that it is taking us today. What I might do is, if I go that way, then I get a little bit of road discovery done. But then heading down the 305, then the 376, past Tonopah, which is where we were in the last episode, I believe. No, we weren't. The previous episode to that. And then if we go down through Las Vegas, we could go past the Hoover Dam if we wanted to, but that's probably the next episode. Past Kingman, Flagstaff, and then all the way up to Kayenta. So this is probably one of the longest journeys that you can do, or maybe not one of the longest, but it is a fairly long journey. Probably longest is Hornbrook down to San Simon or Sierra Vista, something like that. That'd probably be about 1,500, but still a fairly long journey, one of the longest that I've ever done. So if we reset Track IR, let's put the side lights on and let's get going. So I'm using this sort of microphone shield on the Rode Video Micro today. It's not a pop filter, it's one of those sort of furry things that came with the mic. So hopefully that's better, and it just makes it sound a little bit more crisp and easier to hear, but we'll see how that goes. Stop at the stop sign. I think it's perfectly fine starting off in fourth. But yeah, I am interested to see if we can do this on a single tank of fuel. It's saying 1,300 when we just fueled up on the range, and it's 900 and something miles, so according to the truck we can do it, but I don't always trust that range. I don't think it's that accurate, to be honest. So we'll see if we can do an eco drive down here. Alright. Let's have another look at this building. It's all almost wooden. Winnemucca Convention Centre, East Hall. That's what it is. And then we got a casino over there. Look at that. Sansola Casino. Restaurant and espresso. And there's the entrance. Some more shops there. Then looks like a trailer park over there as well. I've noticed there's a lot more trailer parks in Nevada than any of the other states. I don't know why that is, but that's just the impression that I've sort of seen. Right, let's get out of here. Please wait there. Whoa! 20, honestly, are you joking me? Are you actually kidding me? 28%. That guy just completely rammed into my trailer. And just almost toppled it over. Well, that's... we haven't even left the town, and we have completely ruined the job. I don't know if we'd even get paid for that now. We'll probably get about 10 grand. I wouldn't mind that much if it was a shorter journey, but it's one of the longest journeys I've ever done. But I'm not going to cancel it, because I've never cancelled a journey. Oh, that's annoying. I don't know if we're going to get paid, though. If we do 1,000 miles and then we don't get paid, that's... this is definitely going to be a 2-episode. So will it be worth it? Oh, I can't believe that. Honestly, we have had no luck with this truck since we upgraded it. With the 375 engine, it was completely fine. We didn't have any trouble. But it seems like everyone is ramming us now. And we're having so many incidents. And just take a look at the last episode when we almost fell asleep at the wheel. And we get so many speeding tickets with it. Oh, that is stupidly annoying. Well, I guess we need to get a move on then. I mean, how long have we got? We got 37 hours to get it there, and it's saying 22 hours of driving. I'm sure we can get that down. Why did he steer into me? Like, he could, if he waited there, it wouldn't have happened. But the AI just makes such a wide turn. I had nothing I could do then. I was already turning in. Oh. If we don't get paid for this, I'm just going to cry in a corner. Because what a waste that would be. I mean, it's damaged the truck as well, 6%. I mean, if that was in Euro Truck, that would be quite a few grand as well. Now we're on 29%. There's nothing that we can do. 866 miles to go. I'm surprised it didn't blow up. I mean, huge trailer of propane. You saw it toppling over because of, just look at it. That is so annoying. It's quite dangerous, that crash, though, thinking about it. Ramming into a trailer like that. But the thing to think about, it isn't a fragile cargo, so that's not going to affect it. But it is a hazardous cargo. So I'm guessing that sort of means the same thing as a fragile cargo, because if it's hazardous, you've got to be really careful with it, same as you do with a fragile. So I'm really guessing we're not going to get hardly any money for this. Come on, school bus. I've no idea why they all do 60 on here when it's 70. We saw this in the last episode, and we've seen it again. But in Euro Truck news, I don't know if any of you have seen, but SCS released a video a couple of days ago, or maybe it was last week, about, well, it's a bit of a weird video. It's about 30 seconds long, so if you go over to SCS Software YouTube, you'll see it. It's about 30 seconds long. It's like these two people watching a football game, then a truck comes across, and then it shows you the score. I think it's like Italy versus Czech Republic, I think, not too sure, but then Italy won 1-0. So then I looked in the comments to see if anyone really understood the video, and people were saying, does this mean Italy's coming then? And yeah, that probably makes loads of sense. So it looks like they are working, or SCS are working on Italy, which is absolutely awesome. We've had no screenshots or anything, but I'm guessing that video is just to say that they are working on it, or have started working on it. So by SCS's standard, we're probably going to see about, I'd say, Christmas, maybe next year, before we even get Italy, or maybe next summer, I'm not too sure. I'd guess around that time. But it sort of shows you what they're working on next. So we've got no news on them bringing any new trucks to the game. I'd say with this latest update, version 1.28, I don't think they're going to add any more gameplay for a fairly long time now, because they added those double and triple trailers, and I'm thinking SCS believe that's enough gameplay change for a while. So if we would expect then, so maybe the Scania T coming by Christmas possibly. I would say the Renault Range T would probably be next year now, if it even still happens. I don't know, but it seems a bit weird that it's all gone a bit quiet. And I would say that about the Scania as well, that's gone really quiet. Didn't know if I could overtake then, seems a bit risky. No, I'm not going to. Let's just use the engine brake. So yeah, it all seems a bit interesting. So we've got Italy coming now, unofficially. And we have also got New Mexico coming, which should be soon. I really hope it is. But I think it's going to be after Christmas, or maybe at Christmas. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to do as many videos as I would want about it, so I'll probably be fairly busy. I'll probably do a video at the end of the summer of everything that I'm going to sort of plan towards, because obviously I'm back at school and stuff, and I won't have as much time as I do in the holidays that I've got now. Hopefully no one else crashes into me whilst I'm pulling out. Speed now. He's 50. Looks like we're turning right down here as well. It's extremely twisty. Look at this. Something's gone really mountainous around here. Oh, here we go. Seems like a narrow road. Good, no trucks or traffic on it. Get some speed up down here, I think. Yeah, let's just check those damages again. 29 still. I don't think I've ever seen it that bad in this game. And the whole bottom of the trailer is red, so that can't be a good thing. Get up over this hill. Oh, Tesla's going for it. That's probably a bit of a risky thing, driving an electric car through the desert. Or any car, really, when you think about it, because there's hardly anywhere to fill up. And you can't, or is it? I've just noticed. There is a cop car following me. What the chances of this? And then I've got traffic in front of me. How does this happen? I was just turned on to a completely empty road, and then suddenly I've got loads of cop cars and traffic around me. Oh, the game really is tricking me here. I'm probably back down to 40 miles an hour. Past this truck, I doubt that cop car will overtake. I've got no idea what went on then. That car overtook, so I thought, here's my chance as well. I went behind him, they both slammed on their brakes. I'm like, what am I meant to do here? Trapping me. Looks like another gallon trailer up ahead though. Oh, I think I'm gonna go for it. Just keep zoomed in. Oh, this could be risky. Up over a hill. Come on, dude, brake, let me in. Past him at least. Let's try and get some speed up now. Hopefully that cop car stays behind him. Okay. Always seems like we're driving through a valley though. It's never sort of fully flat for a long distance, which I thought it would be. There's always some mountains surrounding you. And there's a lot more sort of vegetation than I would have thought. Like everything seems a bit too green. Wish that was changed a bit. Right, how are we doing on fuel? Apparently we got 670. No, we are not going to do this on one fuel tank. I'm gonna have to refuel at some point. Probably do it in Las Vegas when we get there. get past this guy. So I really don't want to spend too much time on this job when we could not, or potentially not be paid for it. Onto some new tarmac. I wonder what the top speed of this is with the trailer. Assuming it's not massively high. And we have got some twisties coming up, so. Oh, that guy just slowed down to 20 miles an hour for around that corner. We've lost all the momentum. Let's put it in 10th hour. So yeah, that's driving in the desert for you in this game. It's fairly annoying. Sure, there's some trickery going on with the AI. But yeah. So last week I announced with the Exploring France series about how I'm now going to do those sort of bucket list drives. But what I've decided to do is to just stop Exploring France with that episode, episode 4, and then start a completely new series where I do sort of bucket list drives for one series for Euro Truck and one series for American Truck. So say 1 week I can be driving maybe sort of central France through some villages, and then the next week we can be driving through the deserts of America. I think that'd be a cool thing to do, because I do want to do a bit more exciting drives in the games, because especially in Euro Truck I think there's so much map to explore, and the job market doesn't really sort of do a good job of taking you around all the different places, so I thought I'd do that job. I think that'd be a really cool thing to do. Probably do it every week, so a weekly series. I'm not sure how long to do it for, because we do have a lot of games coming. I mean, Project Cars, Gran Turismo, Forza 7. I haven't fully decided yet on what games I am going to do. No idea if to do Forza 7 or not. I'll probably get Project Cars so I can get it on the PC. But if we do that, we then got Project Cars on the PC, Gran Turismo on the PlayStation, and Forza on the Xbox, so that'd be all three consoles sort of sorted, or all three platforms I should say. Is that cop car still behind? I don't think so. Right. Here is Tonopah. May have cut that a bit too tight. Almost hit that sign then. So I've got 29. Yeah, I think we're good for fuel. Still. Almost half a tank though. 5.3 miles to the gallon. Come on, time it. Yeah, that worked. And then straight back out again. They never get any work done in this game, because all the construction stuff has still been here since the game was released. I do like it how SCS have now done these sort of live dynamic events where, for example, the landslide, it just shows you that they are putting some effort into that. But I wish they went back and changed the sort of buildings that are being constructed. So say you deliver to some of the construction sites in this game, I wish they were eventually finished, so it's almost like you've helped to build it. So that would be nice, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case very soon. But they definitely are working in the right direction. I'm not sure what that is. Some kind of weird sign. Just loads of cars just littered about. And some random fence guarding pretty much nothing. Right, here we go. 84, 85, 86, 87. 88. Are we going to go back to the future or something now? 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 95, and I need to slow down. It's a 30 limit down here. Yeah, so 95 got it up to. That's a pretty good score. Oh, cop car. I didn't know if he was going to give me a ticket then. Oh, some cars for sale. It's a bit of an unusual place to sell cars. Oh, tumbleweed. That's kind of cool. Why are they on stilts? It's not like it's going to flood around here, is it? Yeah, I just can't get over that. Why are they selling cars in the middle of the desert like that? When did... That was the loner thing. Back into the hundreds. If we have a look on the map quickly, I just want to see where we are, so... On the 95, we go through that town there, and then we're pretty much in Las Vegas, so we'll probably stop here to fuel up, and then I'll probably end the episode there. What's the time? So yeah, midday. It's currently saying that we're going to get there in 2 in the morning, but that's constantly going down. So I'd say about midnight we'll get there. But saying that, we do need to rest up in 6 hours. Alright, that could be interesting. All these trucks just keep popping out of nowhere in front of you. Just look how quick this range is going down. It's just ticking down. Oh, almost onto half a tank now. Right, I don't think we're going to get past this guy on a straight if we don't hold off a bit. What's he braking for? Oh, it's a 50 limit. Coming into this town. Betty. There's a casino here. Loads of shops around here. I just can't see where everyone's living. Valley that way. Okay. Oh, that's cool. It should be massively hot here then, but it's only in quotation marks 26. thought it would easily be in the high 30s in summer if we're pretty near Death Valley. But yeah, I'm not sure I could cope living there in temperatures like that. Because I prefer cold weather. Winter's my favourite. I'm not a massive fan of summer. Just all the flies and all the bugs annoy me. And I just find it a bit too hot. Let's have a look outside. The rain has stopped now, so it looks like that storm has stopped. Right, let's get back up to speed. So another thing that I have ordered for the Blue Yeti when it arrives is I've ordered a microphone boom stand thing. It's not, it doesn't clamp onto the desk because, as I said, I don't have any place to put it. It's more of a, like a tripod that sits on the floor, which does actually fit where I use it. So I think that's going to be a bit more useful, and it's more portable really. And then the sort of arm in it is actually quite long, and you can tilt it and everything. Whereas with the sort of one that clamps onto the desk, it seems a bit awkward. And the reviews from when I was looking at them said they're all a bit flimsy and probably wouldn't hold that Blue Yeti. So hopefully this boom arm that sits on the ground can support it. It's, I think it's the Amazon's Basic microphone boom tripod something. It's around £17, so it's probably not going to be metal or anything. It'll probably be plastic mostly, but if it works, I'm fine with that. I just need to get it a bit closer to my mouth because the microphones are quite quiet, and then they do pick quite a lot of background noise up, so I do need to get it as close as possible to reduce that. Cop car in front, or was it just a Ford Fusion? I can't tell. I think it might be. I'm just gonna slow it down. I couldn't read it. Some kind of city limit. That looks like a big house, look at that. And some kind of airfield. That's a huge house. Yeah, this looks like some kind of base of some sort. Or the hangars. And then there's like a lake there. Las Vegas, half a mile. Is it a cop car? I cannot. I think it is. I can see the sirens on the top. Right, and we're turning off as well. Oh, there's two surrounding me. Look at this. When do you ever see that? Two cop cars on the road like that? You don't. There's too many of them. Did that plane just turn around, or was that just me? I think it did. And back into Las Vegas. We seem like we always come through here. Got 4 hours until we need to rest. That's not too bad. just looking at the skyline. This is probably one of the biggest cities in the game as well. Just for the effort that's gone into it, a little skate park. It's like a blimp up there as well. Looks like we're going through the centre. Limo, if anyone special's in there. Does seem really slow though, 30 through here. It's like a 3-lane road, 30 miles an hour. Straight through the centre. Another limo. Must be the sort of busiest place for limos around here. You must see them all the time. Look at that, there we go. All the fountains by the hotels. The Eiffel Tower's over there. Oh. We can have a look. Just go external. Look at that. So cool. There's people walking about. Awesome. It is a bit funny how they're not allowed to use brand names though, because they sort of edit them. Like for example, on, I don't know if you saw in the last episode, I think I forgot to mention it, but the realistic John Deere trailer that we're hauling actually said Dear John on the side, which is really funny. Right, let's turn right here. Right on red. There we go, there's another limo. That's three that we see. What? Hang on a minute. What's he giving me a ticket for? Did I not have my indicator on or something? I don't even know. Was there a sign saying don't turn right in red? Again, I don't know. Honestly, they are out to get me. Well, this has been a bit of a rubbish episode. Oh well. I don't think we're gonna fit in here either. I have to reverse onto the road. I'm coming from that angle. Go. Just about made it in. And we have got 78 gallons left, so we burnt 122 in I don't know how many miles. Let's have a look. 500 miles. But yeah. There we go. Thank you for watching that video. If you did enjoy it, please click like and subscribe to watch me continue this journey and find out if we did, well, if we will actually get paid for it. But yeah, that was a bit of a fail, but hopefully you enjoyed the mishaps that went on. But again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.